up against, and it is Fnatic's pick. And yeah. Fnatic have always shown to be, well, show themselves to be a very formidable team on Cobblestone in particular. Olaf Meister is hailed as like one of the best long A or long B players like in the business right now. So basically, like, this is going to come down to the composure that Na'Vi can actually have. I mean, they did manage to run it back on Dust2 quite a bit. They made Fnatic work for it in the end. So that's something, you know, they have some confidence there to go off of, saying, like, okay, we didn't just get railroaded on the first map. We were able to come back and start playing our own game. So something is working there. Now I think it's just going to be coming down to the key rounds at the beginning of this half to give the momentum. Who picks up this pistol, really?
I mean, to be fair, Fnatic did manage to get off to such a powerful start on that Dust2 map that, you know, they just kept rolling, basically. Maybe Na'Vi could prevent that at least from happening. We're going to be in the game right here, and it's going to be Na'Vi starting on CT side. Well, actually, I think they just cancelled the start there as Guardian did nice seize.
Yeah.
We'll see.
I was about to say there, huh? Okay. Yeah, it was not live, so no worries live there. One thing I think, now that we see who's going to get the start on which side, I'm actually going to favor Fnatic on this. I'm actually going to say that we might see like a 9-6 finish here for Fnatic, because they consider it to be a T-side team, a T-side map right now. That's like coming off of Devil Walk, essentially, you know, when he was head coach for Fnatic, when we managed to pick his brain regarding, you know, this map in particular. Essentially, he was saying, yeah, we actually feel like this is going more 9-6, 8-7 T-side, really, that this should be a T-sided map. And so that's what's really wild, considering, you know, for the longest time, we were considering this to be a heavily CT-sided map. But Fnatic right now, I think that they're going to be comfortable whichever side they start on. They get the start on T-side. As far as they're concerned now, as far as the mental game is concerned for them, they should be feeling like they have a bit of an advantage going into this, their home map.
Yeah, absolutely. I would say it's still a map that can change a lot, like a lot can evolve on this map. That's also why I want to take it with like a grain of salt when they say that Fnatic is like this, that they're definitely better than Na'Vi on this map. I think it's true, but it's also like, well, the map is so new still. Like, it doesn't seem like that. If you're like a new Counter-Strike player and you just come in, you think like, well, this map has been in for like 6 months or even more than that now. But actually, in Counter-Strike terms, 6 months is not that much time.
No.
These teams evolve super slowly. We still see people coming up with new things on the map that have been played for like 6 years, right? Or more than that. So it does just take a while before a team starts to really adapt to it. But what we're seeing on this map is that, it's just, especially the B-bomb site, people have such a hard time holding it as a CT because they get sandwiched between drop zone and the plateau. They don't know how to hold it. You get the timing wrong by even a second, and suddenly you're getting shot in the back.
Yeah.
And the teammate that you thought was there, maybe he's already dead, or maybe he's looking the other way. You have some miscommunication about who's looking where, and it's just all going to hell. So that's where I think the big improvement could come. If people actually start to find out, like, really, like, we just saw how good Fnatic were at holding long on Dust2. They could do a similar thing here. Well, it could swing around, but Na'Vi, they're pushing aggressively, and Fnatic, they're going to walk right into the B bomb site. What kind of start is this? Now Flusher going to get the opening frag on Susan. He's going to charge in Flamey, actually. That's C's helping out, saving Flamey for a moment there. And now Fnatic are going to go out.
But they're taking the fight with this bomb.
Yeah,
they're pushing the bomb over towards Na'Vi. They have no idea that there were so many players there for Na'Vi. And now Flamey lying in the cut. He's going to be able to drop one. Crims, though, brings it back near single-handedly, getting those two kills. Still back to a 3-on-2. And now Olafmeister has finally worked his way out onto the B site. But that was way too close. They had no idea what they were about to walk into there.
This is so fun, isn't it? I mean, Fnatic could have walked in, but they didn't know, obviously. Ed was going to get the headshot then, and still no bomb plant. Plenty of time. Guardian gonna make a jump up there, trying to look over the smoke. He must be able to hear Crims through, and he's trying to take the shot, but not really coming out on top. And Edward will go down. Pronax landing a good headshot, leaving Guardian alone here. 1v2, sneaking around, no grenades, no kit. And also just the pistol here. 11 bullets currently in. And they are gonna wrap around both of them, and he's gonna take out one. Another few bullets would have done the next kill in as well, but not gonna be that way. The Fnatic will win the pistol round.
Slow play though from Fnatic towards the end there, and that's also the bit of the issue. You know, you mentioned, you know, the issues that CT side can have holding those kinds of pushes onto the B site, but also then for T side, you know, there's just a lot of open area. If that guy gets behind that little B site wall there, that divider that's next to the tree, next to big box, it could get very tricky for T side to actually, you know, take that fight and get out there, because it's a very hard shot for them to hit. So the fact that Guardian manages to get into that position, I mean, the fact that, well, that's also that Fnatic really, they play that effectively. They play that exactly how you're supposed to, essentially. They don't split up and give them a series of duels. They go one after, they go together and just trade. So there was really no way for Guardian to get out of that position.
No, pretty tough.
Look at that aggression from Na'Vi as well at the beginning of that pistol round. I mean, bit of a gamble for them, but it nearly worked out.
You've done some good damage, Solofmeister. Flusher down to 55-ish HP. And, testing the burst fire on his Glock. That's the best I could try and describe that. For a minute, the timing with the death bonus there actually looked like JW was hitting a no-scope scout shot through the smoke, but that wasn't the case. It was Olofmeister picking up a second kill there with the MAC-10 before he goes down. Flamey will be the guy to take him out with the Deagle. So a little bit of damage being dealt out here but to Fnatic, but it's not too bad. And once again, they're staying as a group like you were just talking about. They, you know, stay together, don't lose any rifles, don't give anything up. Flamey holding close here, actually doing a lot of damage there. Flushers down to 3 health, but Seized will be alone.
And there isn't a whole lot that Seized can do in this position. And he's got his 5-7, he's got Kevlar helmet. It's almost worthwhile for him to be backing off or trying to get into position basically to get an exit kill. If he can be lucky enough to find somebody who's low, i.e. Flusha, if he can actually get somebody to drop an AK for him, that would be a big win as far as he's concerned right now. So that's all he's waiting on, essentially. He's not going to challenge this bomb. Whereas Fnatic right now, they're trying to figure out where Seized is hiding just because they want to be able to get out of here, hold on to the gear that they have. Because so far, this pistol, or this second round anti-eco for them, has actually turned into a bit of an expensive ordeal. They need to make sure that they can get Flusha far enough away so he doesn't go up with the bomb either. And Seized, he doesn't peek at the proper time. He will catch JW, but that's a scout down. Did he actually manage to pick up AK though? That's going to be big. If he can pin down Flusha here, this would be good. But Pronax will be there to rescue his mate. Flusha jumping into the wall, trying to make sure that, you know, the angle isn't there for Seized. That is still a very good round for Na'Vi, dropping 3 players there for Fnatic. Fnatic end up paying quite a bit more than they wanted to that round.
Not too bad, not too bad at all. And again, like, we've seen what happens when Fnatic get a great start, so anything they can do to slow down the pain train, and that's going to be in their favor this round. It's again all pistols here for Na'Vi, no surprise really. Fnatic gone for the double MAC-10 play. They want as much money as they can possibly get. And the flashbang, that was actually a teammate flashing frims then. Well, he's going to be all right anyway. The 2 MAC-10 is doing work already, and Olofmeister tabbing away with it. They're getting 3 kills of MAC-10 so far. That's just so much money to the Fnatic side. And this is essentially, well, maybe not now, but it is close to making up for the people they lost last round. If they could have come out with just the MAC-10s getting all the kills, that would have been perfect.
Yeah, right? I mean, it's a bonus $600 basically per kill there, so versus the 300 you would get with a rifle normally. So, I mean, that makes a big difference as far as the money is concerned. You're absolutely right. And that could make it easier for Olofmeister to get an AWP or to drop one for a JW in the round that comes. So we'll see if they actually go for it. And yeah, they will. So JW does have the money for an AWP. And we can see him picking up the sniper rifle. But unfortunately, Guardian does not have the sniper rifle. So this is going to be this actually puts Na'Vi in a bit of a bind because they do really heavily rely on Guardian to get the job done. And you see there's a clear drop as far as Guardian is concerned when it comes to, you know, working with a rifle versus working with a sniper rifle. He's much more effective with the scoped gun.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Especially because I seem to recall him playing over at A long with that AWP, and he tends to be pretty aggressive. I mean, if you can get a couple of kills early on and then fall back, then suddenly Na'Vi have the advantage and can build something off of it. This time it's an early trade, which will favor Fnatic, because now Na'Vi have to spread themselves even more thinly to cover both the bomb sites here. Fnatic, you can tell they're grouping up 3 people towards the A side of the map, and a little bit of a distraction with Olofmeister again. This is what the panel was talking about as well, playing this plateau and being so damn good at it.
But unfortunately for him, he doesn't catch Edward on the edge of that smoke, and he gets picked off. And Edward could have potentially given that information over to Na'Vi as well. We have that counter rotation coming out now. Flamey working his way back through connector towards that A site. He's got that flash perfectly timed there to slow them just enough to allow him to get up onto balcony. And now Guardian playing from the site. He knows that he has a teammate in position to watch his back. It's going to get tricky for Fnatic. Although, enough damage dealt to Guardian with that Molotov. He gets caught, and now easy kill coming in here for JW. Point blank takes that fight, wins it, but he's still in a 1v2 clutch situation with only 15 seconds to get a bomb plant. It's not looking likely here for the Swede. He has to run fast, and he has to get lucky, basically spot them out, but he's not going to manage it. Gets caught in the crossfire, and that will be Na'Vi surviving with one player in the end. Way too close.
Really close, you're right. JW just showing how, like, what a cool player he is. He's just going for it anyway. 1v3, doesn't matter, like, get the kill, pick up the rifle, try and fight for it with 15 seconds left. He's just ice cold. And this is on LAN as well. There is such a big difference between able to do a play like that online and then doing it on LAN as well.
Yeah.
Very, very cool stuff. Now, the getting the kill on Olof, that's the one thing. Olofmeister is so good at playing that plateau that you can put him there alone, and generally speaking, he will do a lot of damage. But the downside is that when Edward gets the kill, it's such a big tell that something else is up on the other side of the map. It's almost like if you play Nip and you find Get Right, you kind of know the rest of the team is going to be somewhere else, right? It's like, oh, yeah. Well, I found the one lurker. Now I know that they're not here, at least. There's a lot of teams that have that one player. So, yeah, we'll see. But good adaptation from Na'Vi, getting in there quickly and shutting it down.
And I do not think that we are live. Are we live right now?
No, I doubt it.
Definitely not.
I mean...
So, guys... wait, what?
The vent is there, but they're still walking through it. I don't know what kind of magic that is.
They can change out of their corporeal forms? Like, they don't... What?
No clip enabled.
Who are you going to call, Andrews?
The Backbusters? I don't know.
The Backbusters?
Just get these people banned already.
Oh, man, you know, it's always the vacation agents, right? Come to your help you out.
Exactly.
I mean, hopefully somebody will get over there for Edward.
Maybe
if
like
Edward's kicked my PC, I'm going to be really pissed off.
Maybe like the vacagency. To sound like agency, but with vacation, vacagency.
Vacagency.
I don't know. I'm just trying here. Well, at least we got some good shots of the players coming in here. Good work on the cameraman as well. I mean, I don't know. Like that kind of start from Na'Vi. You know, they lose initially, but then once they have rifles, they barely win it.
Yeah.
It makes you like you're happy you win that round, but you're also thinking, damn, now we have to win not just the next one, but the next one again. You gotta get like three consecutive rounds here before you're back economically. Otherwise, you're just gonna be really far down the hole, right?
So it's not a confidence boost. Definitely like that's more of a situation where you're just like wiping the sweat off your brow, saying, yeah. You know, we made it barely.
And so
now,
close.
You know, we got to go into this next one. But again, our money isn't going to be that good. We're going to, like, you want to be able to win a round like that decisively so that teammates can drop weapons and you guys can get a good nade count going into the next round so you can just kind of stomp on Fnatic. But the fact that it's almost a force buy again for you, considering you win the round, but you don't really have enough money for nades. You might have some people skimping, you know, just going for like a FAMAS here and there basically to make sure that they have the nades to go into this round. You know, it can get a little tricky. So... as far as Na'Vi are concerned right now, it's going to come down to this next round. If they can get a decisive win in this next round, that's going to give them a great confidence boost going into the remainder here, and that'll actually rattle Fnatic a little bit. But the fact that I see Pronak standing up does not make me feel too pleased about the situation here. I wonder what's actually happening over there. If we can get an update, that would be lovely, because Edward has got his headset off. Both of these guys right now.
Yeah, something is up. It could be, I suppose, that the server is throwing some sort of hiccup and we're just... And we're just waiting for that to get sorted out.
Mm-hmm.
Good job transforming the Fragbite office as well. You know, this is usually office type space that we've got going on here. And it's just, you know, they made it look smooth and everything. Been working hard, everyone, to set it up here.
Yeah, it has been a pretty concerted effort over here. Quite a good group of people as well. I mean, well, last time around, Fragbite was a great time. And this time around, you know, again, we got a decent crowd. But more importantly, it's just a good closed atmosphere for the players to be able to focus. So you have that going as well. There you have the new head coach for Fnatic, Bugo. So just recently joined up, but he worked with them at Katowice, reviewing demos, et cetera, helping to prepare the team. So there is an existing relationship there. It's not like he just came out of the woodwork saying, hey, guys, I'll coach for you, no problem.
I'll do the coaching.
They had him on the Rolodex.
I mean, the thing is, you kind of have to have some sort of relationship with your coach, don't you? Like, you need to be able to trust... yeah. Whatever the coach says, and like, you know, you got to respect their input a little bit, even if you don't always follow it. So I'm guessing that is important indeed. Right, well, I think they're trying to just swap the servers around to make sure that they don't have any kind of issues. And the whole them climbing through the vents, actually, they couldn't shoot out the vents. That was the bug, so I'm guessing that'll be fixed. That could be like really weird. If the vents stay after you shoot them, then like the decal doesn't go away or the actual texture
just imagine.
Stays.
Clutch situation, basically. You sneak your way through there and then you're hiding on the other side.
Yeah.
Guy would have no idea.
Could be interesting. Well, that means we're just going to have... I mean, it's just going to be like a short timeout here, guys, and we should get right back into it. But with this kind of start, goal for Na'Vi, getting two quick rounds in a row here, shutting Fnatic down. The thing is, if they do get just two rounds... Fnatic probably going to be ecoing, and then they'll start to have a good build-up. Mm-hmm. But I think if it doesn't go smoothly for Na'Vi here in the next two rounds, then it's a pretty good chance the Fnatic are going to just bounce right back and go nuts.
It's just one thing to keep in mind is that Fnatic, you know, none of these early rounds either were very clean for them. A lot of them came down to clutch situations, so they've been spending money too, right? So that is going to be the big thing here. Well, we're going to get to see if they can actually afford a solid follow-up round. Going from there, they should really not have much money. So you're right. We might be looking at a double eco situation here. I'm wondering. Nope. I don't know if we're alive yet or not.
Now we want to stop.
Now we want to stop. So we were alive for a second.
Yeah, like, no, maybe it was some sort of money issue. That tends to happen a lot.
Oh, time wasn't right
on
the
timer. That's important, especially when you're playing Na'Vi. If you play with like a 10-minute round timer and Na'Vi get to play T-side, damn it.
We got time to go make a sandwich before we see anything actually happen on that server.
Yeah, that's going to be a while. All right. Well, I mean, what I'm really curious about is, I bet at some point someone's going to reinvent how to play the plateau area out there. I'm still wondering if it isn't possible for the CTs to somehow push the terrorist team back. We can throw so many grenades over those walls. I'm wondering if there isn't a way to sort of like get a deep smoke and then clear out everything in front of the smoke and just like make sure they don't have that control. Because the threat seems to be that if they get to play on the plateau, then they can time it with the drop zone. But if they're playing further back, then they really can't time the drop zone and the plateau well.
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe you could get a bit of an edge there. I'm still waiting. I feel like more research, more evolution has to happen over at that B-bomb site.
As far as the hold timing is concerned?
Yeah.
I think the joy really is to watch like Olaf Meister and Pasha. This does not look pleased right now.
That's a great face. GIF incoming, right?
Yeah, of course, right? You already see it coming, you know. Front page Reddit.
Someone's going to be on it already. Looking for that free karma.
Yeah, get that karma.
So what do you think, Samla? Who's going to win this? I mean, it's now we've got like a bit of a start. Fnatic winning pistol. Na'Vi bringing back in the fourth round. So we're at 3-1.
It could go either way. Because if Fnatic win this round right now, that puts Na'Vi in a similar situation. Because Na'Vi don't have much money. They win a round. They're almost going to be in like one of those quasi-force buy scenarios now. It's like, yeah, we win. But we don't have much money. So, hey.
Yeah.
Great. You know, what do we do now? So, it's a tricky situation for both teams, essentially. This is going to be the key round right now. As far as winning the map, I still kind of favor Fnatic overall. I still do favor Olaf Meister as far as holding Longview is concerned. And essentially, you know, what's possible with Flush Up and Apartments, JW as well. I mean, everybody's proficient, is very proficient on this CT side and on T side as well for Fnatic.
Yeah, I've got a feeling that Fnatic are going to kick it into overdrive. I'm not sure they're going to... I don't think they're going to give up the next two rounds easily. Mm. I think Na'Vi are going to have to fight for it. And look how happy they all are. Like, the most incredible thing is, like, Fronax's smile is just... I love it. Like, he's got, like, a very characteristic smile.
Yeah, the grin.
Yeah. And he's such a friendly guy as well. All right. Well, we're just figuring out all these issues. Still, of course, we do apologize, but we'll have an update for you guys soon enough. So our technical staff is working hard at it. It's been a rough morning for our tech people, hasn't it?
Dude, they've been like running around basically. I've watched, you know, them put on like 20 years, yeah. Lustrous blonde locks turned to gray, haggard, you know, greasy hair within the space of a couple hours. The stress.
Yeah. Like, that's when you're glad you're just here, you know, doing the casting and relaxing and, you know, smooth, easy, enjoy the game, you know, complain about the delays every once in a while, and then, like, everyone else gets to do
update
the hard work.
Update people on Twitter.
Exactly.
You're like, guys, I swear we'll be back soon.
Yeah.
I say 10 minutes. What I mean is an hour. Why don't you understand that?
And believe us, guys, that, like, the crew behind the scenes, they're quite hardworking, and... I actually wish it was all their fault that this is happening, but it kind of isn't.
It would be a lot of ammunition to use against them in the future.
Yeah, it'd be great. Great if we could blame them, but it's not quite the case.
You got some guys that you work with, you just love to never let them forget, you know, that one time that they messed up. And you forever twist that like a blade, basically. Just, yeah.
Do you have a tiny black book somewhere you keep notes in? You know, it's like, oh, you missed up now.
DreamHack Summer, they did not bring me coffee. Yeah. You know who that is? That's Lurpus.
I was going to say, I think Lurpus is still waiting for that coffee, actually.
He's still waiting for that coffee.
Well, are we actually live? Ooh,
this is looking live
game?
To me.
Yeah, it does look live. So again, apologies for the delays, but it wasn't that bad. A bit of a timeout there. So the smoke goes off and a slightly deeper smoke, but actually the smoke that I was thinking about was going to be even deeper, but I'm not sure if it even works. Either way, Na'Vi are pretty good, heavily stacked up in this B-bomb site. Three people here. Fnatic want to try and push their way through, but oh, they're blocking each other in this corner. Flamey goes up first. Next in line, Edward. Going to pick up a kill and a lot of damage being dished out here. Na'Vi looking great. Sees to take down Pronax and Crims. Last man standing, but only for about a second. Nice hold. That's what Na'Vi needed. Now they need to do it one more time, and then they've got a real shot at a really good first half here.
Yeah, I gotta say, that's actually kind of surprising to see that the Fnatic aren't as smooth. Usually they're such a well-oiled machine when they go together as a group. Very rarely do you see them bumping into each other, slowing each other down. Usually they just execute. They're off of that plateau so quickly. But this time, unfortunately, they spotted Edward, and Edward really slowed everything up for Fnatic. The fact that he locked down the first man, and then that forces the JW to come around. He had the bomb as well, so that forces somebody to run back there for Fnatic to pick up that bomb. So it's a whole series of events basically slowing Fnatic down to the point where by the time they're ready to get off that plateau, they aren't going anywhere.
But kind of a cool mind game as well, holding two people in that corner. Because when you see the first guy running out, he gets a kill, but then you kill him. You're not going to expect the second guy to be there. Quick early trade here as Flamey goes down. Edward there to lock it up, though. Bomb gets dropped, and all of Meister. Well, he gets a kill before the round is over, but it should really be the only thing that gets done here. P250 in hand, looking for a headshot. And he's out of bullets and out of time. 3-3. And Na'Vi, they're right back in the game here. Score is tied. And Fnatic didn't even get a bomb plant that round.
Yeah, and that's a solid anti-eco coming in from Na'Vi as well, so they can start developing that money, as we were saying, basically. I mean, two rounds ago, that was going to be the key round right there as far as the money is concerned. Now, Fnatic are going to be able to get in here. They do have the AKs once again, but no AWP here for JW or Olafmeister, so that's a little bit of a shame there for the Swedes, whereas on Na'Vi's side, Guardian has finally got his sniper rifle. So this is when it gets a little bit difficult here for Fnatic. They try to go for early underpass, or at least we have the anti-rush nades coming out here from Na'Vi. Smoke to block it off as well. Flamey just making sure that nobody can push in through apartments, and he's got Guardian up there as well to watch that angle. So you got Guardian already scoped up, ready and waiting to see if anybody's going to try and poke their nose in here.
Yeah, that Guardian AWP, we saw some really cool examples of it on Dust 2, but to beat Fnatic, they need more. They don't need, like, the cool Guardian, they need, like, the Ultra Beast Guardian, right? And he's going to have to show his face here at some point on Cobblestone for this to work out. Edward, is the timing really that unfortunate? I think Olafmeister just managed to sneak by in that smoke. That's kind of ridiculous because there is a tiny gap here. And you can see Olafmeister walking back in, but now Edward isn't looking. This is ridiculous. It's almost like they've choreographed this.
Yeah, this is crazy, and now it's going to come down to Flamey. But that smoke, perfect timing, thrown in by Guardian, blocking off the door. Pop flash goes through the Flamey, he's holding up close, perfect hold for him. Triple spray down, and that is it. Without having fired a shot, Fnatic get completely overwhelmed. Flusha will take out Guardian in the meantime. So that's interesting, the fact that he's going to be able to start pincering in here with the help of his mate Olafmeister, who's now wrapped around. But that smoke is there, covering Flamey's flank. And so he doesn't really have to worry about the backstab, and he's got his mates having rotated over to the site. Now that he's dropped the bomb, this is pretty much an unlosable situation here for Na'Vi. They should not be giving this up anytime soon, and with only 10 seconds left as well. There's no hope here for Fnatic. If Flusha can make it away, holding on to that AWP, that'd be a big win, but Flamey's one step ahead of him. He sees it coming from a mile away, and they go running right past Olafmeister, who gets the double spray down. So he makes it expensive in the end for Na'Vi. And I don't think Na'Vi could have saved the gun either. They couldn't have saved that AWP, so that's actually double. It's like super expensive for Na'Vi in the end.
Yeah, it is. Good job on Olafmeister, but a great quad kill on Flamey. I'm almost impressed by the fact that he got the first three kills, and none of them were a headshot kill. Like, they were all just spray down. Obviously, what he did is he hit the first bullet with a headshot, and he just, like, pulled down his mouse enough that the rest of the bullets went in the body and killed someone. But, yeah, that was just a little bit unusual somehow. It's going to be the eighth round coming up now. Fnatic are going to go for something that's a little bit more classic Fnatic here. Because on Dust 2, they actually did a bunch of buys where they didn't get armor, but they just got pistols. And now we've got the armor pistol, which is one of the big strengths of this team, is just being able to buy with this kind of buy and make it work. And they are again. Oh, no. It's like history repeating itself right here. Flamey hiding in the corner, but they're on the bomb side. Bomb goes down, and Fnatic, they don't have a lot of health, but at least they have three people left alive now.
JW trying to make it out of there in one piece. He gets picked off immediately by Flamey, who has two kills for now. But yeah, everybody's so very low on Fnatic's side means that they need to take these shots and they need to be decisive when they do take the duel. And there's Crims, runs out of bullets and not going to be able to make it out in one piece. Yes, he does, just barely, but he gets overwhelmed. And now it's into a 1v1. Pronax still alive versus Guardian, who's also on 40 HP. Pronax with that Tech-9 trying to get up here up close. Guardian running out of time on this bomb. He needs to land this shot fast, and he's not going to make it out of here in one piece. Throws away the guns, and Fnatic will bring this back to a 4-on-4, or four rounds, basically, off of a pistol force.
Oh, I'm wondering if Guardian wanted that smoke to go down differently. He couldn't. I don't know. Guardian had very little information in that 1v1. That's really tough to play. Hard to criticize him exactly for how that played out, but from our point of view, it looked like if he had put the smoke down right on the bomb and just held it, maybe he would have had a better chance of doing it. But that's, I don't want to question it too much. It's a lot easier making that call from where we're sitting, essentially.
Of course.
Yeah. JW running on through here, UMP in hand, and this is the problem, right? Na'Vi win four rounds in a row, but because they're all so expensive, like we were talking about that one play from Olofmeister, it means Fnatic at least win the one, and then Na'Vi are in a position where it's like pistols and armor, trying to see if they can keep it alive here. That one investment for Fnatic, that their own pistol armor buy, paid off so well. Whew.
Look at Wolfmeister down to six. He's gonna have JW there to do the, to finish the job essentially, and that's gonna be Guardian and Zeus, the last two players alive, but on opposite sides of the map. Guardian starting to work his way through to underpass, but Zeus holding in drop down room, just hoping to get lucky here. And he might get rewarded for his patience. With the Swag 7 in this position, this could get nasty for Krims, who's thinking about coming through here, but they're actually going to gather up here from on Fnatic's side, and I do like the fact that they elect to just group up. So if they take a fight, one of them gets taken out perhaps, but the others are going to be there to get that refrag, be able to get onto that bomb site, get that plant. They just want to make sure that they have everybody alive at the end of this round right now, because maintaining their money, or building rather a strong economy, is pretty much the only thing that Fnatic have in mind, apart from obviously getting the rounds on the board. So that plant should be happening fairly soon. And then it's basically going to come down to whether Zeus and Guardian can manage to get into a sneaky position to find somebody from Fnatic and get a free kill. Zeus, this is going to get nasty here. JW, does he decide to push in here? Got the pop flash. Zeus turns away, and he just turns back too early there. Gets full flashed, and that's an easy kill for JW.
Yeah, pretty good timing. Nobody dying on Fnatic just yet, and Guardian looking for some sort of exit frag, which feels like he's not going to get. I think JW, is he going to run out the other way? Yeah, he will, so no one's coming Guardian's way. So 5-4 here, and Na'Vi's economy, I mean, because they went for pistol and armor and everything, I think that vent's still looking a bit dodgy there, but hopefully it won't be a big issue. Some sort of bug in the map, potentially, or the server, I'm not sure which is responsible. So, I mean, I actually thought that Na'Vi getting the three consecutive rounds there, that was going to be enough to really get the whole thing rolling.
Yeah.
But you can tell that Fnatic, they're so hard to stop, right? Even when you slow them down, you feel like now we've put them in their place. And they somehow retain a lot of that momentum and they bring it right back.
The splash timing here for Edward up close. Gonna get overwhelmed. No Kevlar there to mitigate the aim punch. And Seize runs right back into a headshot from Flush. A Flush on point right now. Two headshots for him so far. JW, he knew the economic situation for Na'Vi as well, so he elected to hold on to his UMP. Gets dropped down to 34 HP, but he's looking to just farm up that money. Wants to see how much of a bank he can get before he's forced to spend it on an AWP. So smart play there by JW. Good awareness of the economy for Na'Vi. As far as Flamey, Guardian, and Zeus are concerned, once again, they've gathered up here, and this is actually an ideal situation for Na'Vi.
Wow.
Even though they're getting picked off one at a time, they still have two players here on this A site.
See if they could do just a little bit of damage here. I mean, again, they need to take some of these rifles away from Fnatic. Just make sure they don't get out of round like this with too many kills. But it's going to be another two UMP kills, which is also going to be a bit better for them. And Fnatic now up at six rounds and just continuing to put on the pressure here. Na'Vi, surely they've been preparing for this round. Now they're getting themselves mentally ready. They know they have to stop Fnatic right now. Otherwise, it's going to get out of control. They've got the AWP.
What?
They've got a lot for it. Yeah, and they're just keeping on to the UMP. JW doesn't care.
JW's like, I'm going to go take Guardian's AWP. Hold on, give me a sec, guys. And he's actually going to run in there, and he gets some running headshot on the Guardian.
Who had no head armor.
Gets the AWP.
That's why he didn't buy one, Semler. He was ready for it. Gonna miss the shot there. Goes for a re-peek, and Susanette will pick up a kill each. So actually, Fnatic probably throwing away a bit of a lead there, and now Pronax is gonna be alone to try and close out the round. That's kind of the downside of playing like JW does, but it works so often you can't really blame him for it. And that's gonna be Zeus picking up the last kill and making it around for Na'Vi. That right there is the perfect example of what happens if you don't buy head armor. But I mean, in Guardian's case, you understand why he makes the choice.
Yeah.
It's still just, oh, that's painful.
You got to give it to Zeus and Edward for bringing it back, though. That was definitely scary.
Yeah.
But yeah, running UMP shot to the face like that, you're right, man. That is heartbreaking. Still, I mean, JW, he's going to have the money to full buy his AWP now. No problem at all. His Guardian, he has one as well. And you can see him not quite there. Yeah, he's going to go for the aggressive A take, essentially, try and get into these apartments and see if he can't catch somebody just making their way into underpass. Whereas JW's elected to do the same, actually. So Guardian now walks in, and Flusher was ready and waiting, laid that trap, and Guardian took the bait. So now all of a sudden, Na'Vi are a man down here holding on this situation. They still got three guys on B, but they're starting to rotate back towards A. That's Zeus, who's coming back to support his mate, Seized, who's holding up in A apartments for now.
Yeah, and I think they were just throwing that gun, the AWP, out of the side of the castle, basically. Just down the side of the mountain there, because that way nobody from Na'Vi can go and pick it up later on, try and save it, anything like that. Looks like it's going to be a play for B, and we'll see the sandwich effect that we were talking about. This is going to be so rough right now for Flamie and Sushi holding in this bomb site, because they're going to get sandwiched in. Or I think it's Edward over here, in fact. Pronax coming close. Flamie there. Actually going to get a great opening kill. Needs another one. He's going to get it. Crims goes down. Great job on Flamie. And now Edward taking a fight. He should be playing it safely. And he ends up dropping next in line. Sushi to pick up a kill. But he goes down. And this is working out for Fnatic. 25 seconds. And they can get the bomb plant.
And they know that Flamie's still in drop-down room as well right now. So they've got information on one of the players. They can assume that another one was actually going to be coming through on connector. But instead, Seize is going to come out through long. So he may be able to drop. He may be able to stop this bomb from getting planted, depending on the angle that JW goes for. Or are they already a step ahead? Olafmeister watching from Henhouse. Not going to get the kill on Seized. Instead, now it's JW 1v2 trying to predict where they're coming from. Unfortunately for him, he does not. He does actually hit that, but I think he clipped the stone. And now it's going to get overwhelmed, of course. Crossfire situation there for JW. No, nothing he could do, essentially, once Seized managed to get through there. But I'm amazed that Olafmeister, even knowing where Seized is coming from, he was already watching long there, and he still fails to get that kill.
Sick round from Flame. The fact that he got two kills like that to begin with the FAMAS was incredible, and last one as well. He's also top fragging on the Na'Vi side. Really, really great job on his part. The one thing that almost threw this round away, I think, was actually Edward. The reason, like, you're normally, if you're playing where Edward is by the statue on the bomb site, if you play aggressively like he did, you're doing it because you know that if you fall back, you're gonna be sandwiched in from drop zone. But because Flamie just took out two people, they could have just said, let's just play it slow, let's wait until we're all here, and then we'll face them. They're not even in the bomb site yet, we can just, you know, take it easy. But I think Edward almost gave up that round just by challenging early on. Otherwise, they would have been in the 4v3 and they would have had a much easier job of taking that round. So maybe a little bit too aggressive, I think. But Olafmeister playing plateau once again. And grenade going to come out, do a little bit of damage, but he's going to be careful here. JW opening up. How is Olafmeister not dead?
Whoa, and he nearly takes out Edward there with the running gun. He's going to go back for more as well. That sets it up. Zeus has been spotted. Pronax is going to know exactly where he is now. Manages to hunt him down. Edward and Flamie both having dropped very low as well. This makes it very difficult. Great adjustment coming out here, but Guardian's one step ahead. Point blank misses the quick scope, and Pronax is going to get that kill and following kill on Edward as well. Easily done here. Great round from Pronax so far, having picked up a triple kill. Now he's got an AWP as well, but he decides to stick on that AK. They're already predicting where the last man is going to be coming from. Flamie to get picked off point blank by JW, and that, yeah, Vugo giving the pat on the shoulder there. That was a big round from Pronax.
Yeah, absolutely. The big turnaround there as well for the smoke, really nicely handled. I love the sequence of flashbangs that go down into drop zone, because the first one forces the CT player back, but then when he's actually back in the room next to it, he still gets flashed by the follow-up flashbang. So he was really flashed for like a good 6 seconds or something there. Really annoying. And speaking of flashbangs, there's a lot of them in the middle here, and Flush are going to be the first man through his pistols on the Na'Vi side. So good job on Flamie picking up the opening kill, and Guardian to take down Pronax. This is looking very good indeed.
Yeah, the Seize has got an AK to play with now, as well as a Molotov. Not going to get anything out of that though, JW. And this is now going to get a bit tricky here. We do have Olafmeister having worked his way out onto this B site already. And what? Zeus gets that kill point blank on Olafmeister. This could very well turn into Na'Vi picking up this round. Two-man advantage now makes it very tricky here for Fnatic, and Edward watches him go jumping right past. Krims catches out the lurk, though.
Who does that?
Oh my god, Krims so on point, and now can they actually get out onto the A site?
Who actually checks once their teammate has already run by? It's one thing for you to check if you're alone there, but when you're the second man in, that's uncommon. That is so sick. Krim's gonna pick up a headshot as well there. Krim's finally goes down, but then sees to drop, and JW, he's got the time. Guardian has to find the perfect timing here. Picks up the AK, sprays, and it's gonna be the kill. And you're right, Na'Vi, they'll bring it back in. This is great. I think 7 rounds is actually super impressive from Na'Vi. They're on the verge of a terrific first half here. I was expecting Fnatic to get like at least 10 rounds in this first half. That's what I was looking for.
Yeah, at least, like, I was thinking 9-6 worst case scenario for Fnatic, essentially on T side, but They are putting up one hell of a fight right now, Na'Vi. And these kinds of mistakes, these kinds of rounds like that, the Na'Vi are allowed to pick up when they have, you know, just a couple of pistols, upgraded pistols, the majority of them still on standard issue. That's insane, the fact that Na'Vi managed to catch Fnatic off guard like that. And now, well, Olafmeister peeks forward and doesn't hit the angle correctly there. Edward is going to catch him out, and JW aggressively hunting down Zeus, knows that there's a mana connector, looks for the pregame there, and he's not going to be able to get that kill. Flamey lives with 2 HP, nothing going Fnatic's way in this round.
Could be Na'Vi essentially getting the majority of the rounds here on the first half. And remember, Na'Vi are fighting to extend this best of three. Fnatic, they took it to them on Dust 2 and ended up winning. 16-13 was a close game, but the whole first half was just Fnatic ripping Na'Vi apart.
Yeah.
And more or less the same happened on second half, except Na'Vi was ripping Fnatic apart, but then it came to an end. Pronax there, good kill on Seuss, but he's still very low. 20 health.
And now it comes down to the B, and are they going to be able to actually get this done here? There's Edward already holding on the other side of the box. They decide to check this angle. Flush up peeks, picks up one kill, but then Edward, double kill for him, locks down long, and that leaves Pronax all by his lonesome here. 20 HP, gets picked off in the end. 15 rounds, 8-7 will be the final score of this first half with Na'Vi. You're right, just edging out the win in the end. So nicely done there by Edward with the triple kill. And he's just like, yeah, guys, I know. That's kind of, they just came to me, man. It was easy. Like for him, no sweat off his brow, right? It just looks all easy there.
I've got it covered. Now, definitely a good first half here for Na'Vi. Whether it's enough to actually win, I mean, that depends, I think, a lot on what Na'Vi have planned for the T side here. But I was expecting more out of Fnatic. So in that sense, I don't know if I'm excited for Na'Vi or if I'm a bit disappointed for Fnatic. But I guess it all amounts to the same thing, which is a decent first half here.
As far as the rest of them are concerned, I mean, we can see the talk going on right now. I mean, this is obviously going to be the key round. And we have the replay coming up from Edward now. Essentially, his solid hold here at long. I mean, this is just big work. And the fact that he managed to pick up Olafmeister early on as well, because they were going for a boost initially there, Na'Vi, trying to get him up in position. Olafmeister had the timing down right, but he didn't play the angle correctly. Unfortunately, yeah. He just kind of like over-aimed a little bit, and Edward was able to just spray him down. So that could have changed the entire round had that gone south for Edward at the beginning of it.
I mean, I don't know. I'm sort of wondering what this half would have looked like if Guardian had been on fire, you know.
Yeah.
Because this is Flamey doing really well. If Guardian had been there too and done super well, you got to wonder if they could have actually crushed Fnatic instead. Cool boost coming up here in the middle of everything. They're really expecting Fnatic to come up with some aggression. So this is a clear sign. You can tell these teams have had a bit of practice going on. And they got Seuss to spot it up here. They've got a crossfire that extends from the connector in middle all the way up to the sniper spot. That's the longest crossfire I've ever seen in my life. But it's just a sign that they've obviously experienced, or they've looked at Fnatic demos and seen that they like doing that. But Fnatic instead are actually playing stack towards B and just have Flusher as like the one guy holding A and checking out and seeing what's going on. And he moves out of the way just when Na'Vi are about to go. Actually, JW takes his place. So now they see it coming and are going to go for the long-range fight.
And he decides to back off as well. He doesn't force the issue there. So that's going to force the rotation now from the rest of Fnatic. JW taking this fight, trying to dance around the edges as best he can. They are burning valuable time off of this clock, but if they can't get some kills here, it's going to fall apart here. JW finally with the two headshots, he delivers, and Flush is still alive on this site, calling out the Guardian, was moving towards Connector. Guardian, nonetheless, will pick up a kill, but it is going to be him alone now. Having run into Connector, he's going to make the dead sprint for the B site. He manages to slip through the net.
Yeah, but here's the crazy thing, Samla. He's got 12 bullets and one outside of that, and he's got three duels to kill. This is going to have to be some good headshots. He can't waste bullets. Going to have to just click away one thing at a time here. Headshots is the only thing that will win this round for Guardian. He's looking for an ace as well. There's one. He's looking for more, and now he's got one bullet left. He can't do it. And Olafmeister is there. They've got the kit as well on Pronax, and Fnatic are going to win the round. Man, that is so tense, isn't it? He had very, very little room. He's got like four bullets per player to try and do that with. So four clicks at a headshot. If he uses more than that, it's just not going to work out, is it? That's scary.
The 1v3, right? How epic would that have been, though? He's tracking well. If he just had a couple more bullets there, he might have actually turned that into a 1v1. And then everything changes.
Yeah.
Even if he isn't in an ideal position for that plant, it's definitely possible. And now we're going to have Na'Vi going for the force buy, basically. Crims waiting to receive them. And with the MP9, he gets dropped on by Flamey. And Flamey, once again, is a god in underpass. Two kills for him. Tech 9 gets the headshots up close, and that's what's so scary about Underpass. That close quarters right there. The fact that the Tech 9 can just come around at any time, and at such close range, that instant headshot, you're done, you're doomed. And we just saw that from Flamey. Two kills so quickly.
Love the fact that Na'Vi is putting out this kind of aggression, right? It's something they've started doing a lot more recently, which is this early AK buy with armor, and then everyone else is just with pistol armor. Because they got the bomb plan, and the sort of traditional way, if you want to say, is obviously to wait for the round coming up and then for everyone to have an AK. But especially against Fnatic, I like the idea of putting the pressure back on them. I think you can't allow Fnatic to get away with having too much of their own style in here. You need to keep them off their guard. Make sure that they are nowhere near their comfort zone, essentially.
As far as the time is concerned, now there's 30 seconds left for this slow play from Na'Vi to work, and they have finally been spotted out. JW in position to hold, and he did have pressure for a little bit there, but now it starts to get a little bit tricky. Long range, long distance spray, and he gets overwhelmed. They turned it into a 1v1. They've made this a very expensive round, and Edward up close with the AK could get the job done here versus Olafmeister. But Olafmeister gets that timing just right to come around the corner, spraying with the MP7, and he gets the win in the end. So Fnatic, just like what was happening with Na'Vi as well on their CT side.
Yeah.
It's incredibly close. All these rounds to start off the half. Na'Vi are putting on excellent pressure right now.
Now, that much damage, you got to wonder what Na'Vi are going to do. And look at this. They will buy. That is actually super cool. They didn't get the bomb plant, so they're short a lot of money that they needed for this kind of thing. But they realize that Fnatic are close to breaking. And Fnatic only have, look at this, 3 submachine guns, 1 AK, 1 M4. Not the most heavy equipment, but a great double grenade followed up with a Molotov to keep Na'Vi honest up here. JW playing close to the smoke. It's only a one round difference. Na'Vi are thinking, if we win this round, we're going to win the next one, maybe even two rounds. Fnatic are going to be plain broke, and we've got a decent chance of doing this.
Let's see the setup now. I mean, it's going to be a slow invade here for Na'Vi towards this A site. 4 players here, one of them lurking outside of underpass, but 3 players with the bomb have now made their way up into apartments, and there's the entry. Zeus taking out Flasha, opening up this bomb site, and now you got JW peeking through this smoke, hoping to find somebody, and he will. He actually catches Flame, a flaky long distance with the MP7. Will not win the duel versus Zeus, however, so once again, momentum kind of shifts back towards Na'Vi, but with 40 seconds left here, Na'Vi, they still have a little bit of time to slow play this, try and catch Fnatic out of position.
Yeah, I'm wondering if Fnatic saw the bomb because they're rotating on in. And, I mean, 40 seconds, it's going to take a while to get back to B. It's actually a little bit tricky. So, Pronex up here, MP9 in hand. Could he really seal this round? Edward's going to go checking for it. There's Pronex. Takes down one. 20 seconds left here, and Olafmeister's going to be in a 1v2. He drops Guardian, and the bomb has not been planted yet. Seuss, he can be covered while putting down the bomb, so he could be doing that, but he's still going to have to find his way out. He's currently got a triple kill, looking for one more. Olafmeister, he clutched it last time, and this time he's going to try and do it again. Seuss, looking the wrong way, and when he comes back in, he just gets the kill, surviving on one health. It's ridiculous, but it works, and it's a quad kill as well. Yeah, a bit of a high five then. I don't think that was with, like, a lot of confidence, but it was enough. It made it work. And that means it's worth it. Great, great job on Na'Vi. That's a question of like, doing risk assessment and thinking to yourself, is it worth it? Do we, like, if we force it one more time, does it pay out? And it does. And then Fnatic, they make the exact same calculation and decide, well, we could do it too. It's what we do after all. It's our thing, right?
Straight up pistol force buy. So now, I mean, that's it. We're at the beginning of this happening. They still refuse to give any ground here, either team. As we saw from Na'Vi, a series of force buys on their side. Fnatic showing that they're not... No, they're... Their eyes aren't cold. They're willing to go for the fight as well. Although Olafmeister right now taking one hell of a beating over here on Long B. He's going to have to back off and try and change positions. But he also didn't have much invested in this. I mean, he was sitting on a P2000, not a P2000, on a USP. Not too bad a situation for him. But now it's going to be straight up peek behind on overpass. They are on drop room. They've managed to take out JW. Crims will return. And there's a perfect flash by Pronax. Does he actually get the follow-up, however? Trying to slow things down here, but they are going to take advantage of this smoke, Na'Vi, and start working their way through connector, perhaps.
Grenade on in. Almost looked like it could have been a team grenade, but not going to work out that way. Flusher will take down Flamey, and it's up to up to Flusher again. Last man standing. Dropping Seuss as well, making this very expensive, if nothing else, for Na'Vi. It's going to be hard for him to win the round. He's got the smoke, but he doesn't have a kit, so putting up a smoke and defusing for 10 straight seconds is not very likely. And Guardian will put an end to it. So, I mean, yeah, they're making Na'Vi work for this. But Na'Vi seem to actually be coming out on top here. This could be very interesting, because just to remind everyone, the third map in this series is Mirage. And Na'Vi, I mean, actually both teams are damn good at playing Mirage. But Na'Vi sometimes, I mean, they have a reputation as being the best, essentially.
Yeah, last two times these teams have faced on Mirage, Fnatic have won. But they've both been very close wins.
You gotta wonder if, like, this is the thing, right? Maybe Na'Vi's, like, the best team at playing Mirage, but then Fnatic is, like, the best team overall. So it's like, does that cancel out somehow? I mean, if it's going in favor of Fnatic, maybe it just means Fnatic are that good. Or they're just also getting better on Mirage. This round, kind of a cleanup here. No trouble at all. And Na'Vi need a lot of these rounds. They need the money. They need to make sure that if Fnatic ever get a round here on the second half again, then Na'Vi can just continue to buy forever, forever, ever.
Forever, ever?
Yeah. Seized. Spraying down there, catching Pronax, who was just trying to get a tour, you know, the museum up there, look at the armor, some of the medieval stuff, and I don't know, man. It's kind of rough. Maybe he didn't pay his entrance fee, but there's no reason to kill him.
That's kind of brutal, especially when he's curious, and he's like, well, I have a gun now, but what did people kill each other with before?
Can I steal one of these for the next round? Just spear someone?
He's like, this knife is a little bit too nouveau, you know, new age for me. I'm gonna go with this flail.
I personally wouldn't go with the flail. I feel like if I did, there is it's like a 50% chance I'd beat myself to death instead.
Yourself,
you know?
Yourself in the face.
Yeah. Like, I don't think I can control that.
I mean, dude, those things do look tricky, but I mean, at the same time, that whirling, just boom. I don't know, man. That sounds, like, brutal. Like, that is, like, just definition of brutality right there.
A sword or a spear or something, you know, sticking with the pointy end. I can manage
get that.
That
together.
I can manage that. JW down here waiting, and it's going to be a good kill there on Guardian, who was actually expecting, I think, a different angle. You can kind of tell that he had a different thing in mind there. Grenades raining on through, and tag up JW a bit, but still a good return kill. Oh, sorry, a good amount of return damage there, down to 45. And it's 11-9 currently. Scoreline favoring Na'Vi. They did get the majority of the rounds on the first half as well. Even though this is supposedly a terrorist island map, we know how to play it well. Oh, and Pronax and Crims each getting a kill, meaning Edward and Seuss are going to be left. And it looks like this is where Fnatic say enough is enough.
Yeah, that crossfire setup that they really do favor Fnatic in drop-down room is brutal. When Pronax and Crims start clicking together as a unit, that's when they peek, they cover for each other. They just know the timings down. They have the timings down so well. Edward gets eventually overwhelmed after taking out Olafmeister. No harm there, really, in the end. And Olafmeister, they're going to be able to save whatever rifle you had if they need to, so it's not going to be a problem. But Fnatic and, yeah, the man in question, Pronax, basically, the mastermind behind the team, that's some very great work from them, although this was the start here. JW, he stops Guardian from taking an aggressive peek, essentially. Manages to open things up, puts the pressure on Na'Vi, and then the rest of his teammates kind of just come together, essentially, to clean up that round. So really nicely done there. And that's one round closer to the goal here for Fnatic. 10-11 the score, though, so they still have a long way away, or ways to go. And Guardian is scoped up on this. JW, do you really want to go for it?
He's somehow feeling it. You know, you gotta wonder if he gets close enough, if he can feel, like, you know, the heat on his shoulder, like some sort of early warning. Like, I'm not sure what it is, but something's telling me that
it's a disturbance.
I'm a pixel away from death. But he spots the shadow of Seuss, and that's what gave it away there. Misses the next shot, and it's almost like he shakes his head in frustration as Edward just unloads. And that's gonna be it now. 4v4, more than a minute left, and Na'Vi, to prevent the equalize here, they're gonna have to win. And maybe put Fnatic back on more ecoing. That would be great for them. Otherwise, you never know with Fnatic. Oh, look who's sneaking up behind. Are they going to catch each other? Guardian looking for an entry here. But Olafmeister does, in fact, come up from behind, taking out Seized. And that's a big kill. Look at all the information Olaf has now.
Yeah, Seized nobody. Now they can have that rotation coming out from Pronax already through connector towards the A site. They already have two guys holding solid on the A site. And Pronax just waiting for the proper timing. Gets that peek, does get the info, spots out too, and the bomb as well. So now they know. They didn't know before, now they're certain. And Olafmeister, perfect kill on the Guardian. This is actually shaping up to be very good here for Fnatic. A second kill comes in for Flusha, who holds the line from the site. Flamey steps forward to try and take out Olafmeister connector, but he will not be successful. Fnatic will bring it back to 11-11 with three members surviving and even managing to save the AWP off of Guardian as well. So a lot of money saved there for JW. Not going to be the end of the world. They wouldn't have been able to recover his AWP, so that's very important for Fnatic, essentially. They need to build that strong economy. So if you can save a $4,750 rifle, Anders, that's good money right there.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. It's going to equalize the score 11-11, and now V, instead of getting the eco on Fnatic, they're themselves ecoing here. Edward out on an adventure towards the A side of the map, with the rest of Na'Vi grouped up towards B. And I'm not sure any kind of venture through the smoke is going to be super successful. Maybe if they can get the instant kill on Olaf, but the fact that he's already playing defensive makes that really tough. And there's a good kill, second kill as well. Olaf with five bullets left. Going to land another headshot. Please, someone stop Olaf Meister. They just can't. That's a triple kill, and Krohn actual takedown sees. That's so smooth. We've got to have a torture replay of that. That looked so cool.
Those aren't easy shots to hit either. Let's see here.
No, you tend to panic if they're that close. Olaf is just like, oh, I'm even getting a bit tired. It's too easy for me. It's just easy.
Shrug, man.
Yeah.
It's great to hear that. It's great to hear. Haha, because Olaf Meister just had ear surgery, right? So, I'm glad that it doesn't seem to be affecting his game. He was a little bit worried about it going into to today's matches, but seems like past that now. He's actually doing fairly well right now. JW with the aggressive hold and underpass once again with that AWP, looking to see if anybody's going to be setting up there for Na'Vi. But Na'Vi have got other plans in mind. At least for now, they have set up on long, and some good spray there from Olaf Meister tagging them up. Seized and Zeus already having suffered some damage here at the beginning of this round.
Yeah, I've got a funny story about Olaf Meister in a second, but first of all, no fun in games there as Edward goes down. That's Olaf picking up the kill, and Crims with a good kill on Flamey. I think he wanted to get into position Flamey to punish that kill while Olaf was reloading.
Yeah.
And there was just no chance for it either. Zeus was going to go down as JW. How did he win that fight? Oh no, Guardian going to get the shot on Pronax, but it's a 2v4 right now, and it looks like Fnatic are about to take a big step towards 2-0-ing Na'Vi here. The CIS team, they won't have the money if they start losing now. They were just decoying, and they're going to be doing it again soon.
35 seconds left. Do they commit? JW now knows. Now a Guardian's going to go down to Crims regardless, so before JW can even take that shot, it's going to be seized. Did he find a way? They already have the rotation coming out, though. Flush and connector, so he's got the help of Olaf Meister as well. Olaf Meister might just go looping up on the balcony, and Flush are watching the doors. Nicely done there. Good communication between Fnatic as far as which angle is being covered.
Yeah.
And that's going to put Fnatic up on 13 rounds now.
Before we started the show here, we were actually talking to Olaf Meister a bit. It was Richie Lewis and I was standing around, and Vendetta showed up, and we were talking like, how's your ear actually? Is it all right? And he said, yeah, it's actually pretty good right now, but I still got to be careful, not to stress it too much.
Yeah.
But things are good, generally speaking. That's, good stuff there. Definitely one of the, if not one of the best, then maybe the best player in the world at the moment. And Vendetta says, do you think there's a chance it could get worse? Which somehow is taking the darkest possible outlook. It was very funny at the time.
You gotta be a realistic man.
Is there a chance your injury could get even worse? Olaf didn't look too happy, but it's kind of funny. And he's once again sneaking up behind here to get another kill in, and they're just trying to basically feed him more kills. Double for Olaf Meister once again. Flamey and Edward are gonna be left 2v4. And we'll see if they can do something here. Flamey's already gone down, so now it's all on Edward. There is almost no best case scenario left right now. Fnatic are about to take a 14th round. If Edward can't stop, then there's one kill, and JW picks up a double, and that's 14-11. Semler is looking so good, and now all of a sudden, the lead that Na'Vi had and whatever confidence they had, it's been eroded.
It's just falling apart. And like we were saying before, or at least as far as Devilwalk's opinion is concerned, that this is developing into a T-sided map, and that a strong team on this map in particular should be able to crank out the rounds. We saw a little bit of that from Na'Vi earlier on, but now Fnatic are just saying that, hey, once we get the money, once we get the confidence, we're going to just start pushing everywhere across this. We're going to be ultra-aggressive, and you aren't going to be able to deal with it. Out to 14 rounds now, Fnatic, to Na'Vi's 11, and it's another force buy coming out from Na'Vi, and that's the other issue here, is that Na'Vi, they gamble with the forces, and so that leaves them in a much more difficult situation, because you have Zeus, who's just on a Tech 9. Sure, everybody else has got rifles, but they have no nades to work with, so it makes their job even harder.
Flick on there, does actually tank Guardian in the legs, and JW's gonna come pushing through the smoke, and that is exactly what we expect from JW, but you can tell how hard it is for Na'Vi to predict that it's happening. He's not gonna check the corner and ends up going down to Guardian, who's also alone. 5 health in a 1v4. Samuel, I've watched all the Disney movies. I like to believe that the little guy is gonna win, but this time, I just don't believe it.
You mean to tell me that this is closer to real life right now?
Yeah, I think.
Are you being realistic, Anders?
I think Guardian is about to get destroyed here, and with that, probably Na'Vi as well. I don't see an easy way out of this one.
Yeah, there's no real light at the end of the tunnel here for Guardian, really. I mean, he's got that AK, but 1v4, all the angles covered, 20 seconds left, and there's the shoulder peek. And there's the kill coming through for Krim. So, I mean, Fnatic right now, they look so cool, calm, composed, and they are the defending champs. We just have to remind you of that. So,
yeah,
they came back, and that's how dominant this team has been, the fact that they're able to come back through into the next year and start defending titles that they won last year.
Yeah.
Granted, it was towards the end of last year, but still, I mean, it's one hell of a stretch that Fnatic have been one of the best teams, if not the best team in the world.
Yeah, it's real impressive. It's real impressive. 15-11, and the 27th round. Na'Vi now, similarly to what was happening on Dust2, they need to win four in a row to get the overtime, and they're starting off great. They're still staying in the fire. They're going to be careful. Edward barely surviving. Olofmeister trying to fight it back. Picks up an AK and goes back for Guardian. That's brilliant. And now Flush is going to take out Flamey, and Olof is controlling the bomb. That's Flusher taking unseized. Oh no, it was looking great. But then between Flusher and Olofmeister, they crush the whole Na'Vi team, and it's down to Edward, 3 health. He almost burned alive, and now it's going to be the headshot to finish it. And Na'Vi, they go down to Fnatic, who 2-0 them on Dust2 and then on Cobblestone. I like that last little bit at the end there. M4 for the first kill, goes back in the smoke. And